where do I really go? You know, do I trust or do I find a way to control? Because those are the only two options that I really have. And the work of the Holy Spirit is always to move you in the direction of wholeness. And wholeness is when the way of your being matches the truth of your being. And so a lot of lies about what we think about ourselves or about life or about death have to be exposed so that we can be free to be ourselves and therefore fully of God as well. Because we're made in the image and likeness of God, which is the truth of our being. Yeah. But how is the way of our being ever going to match it? Well, we're in a world that's full of brokenness, and these all become opportunities to learn what the truth of our being is so that the way of our being can match it. And you know this, one of the names for the Holy Spirit is the Comforter. And you know, here's an interesting thing. The Holy Spirit throughout the Hebrew scriptures was feminine. The language is feminine. Starting in verse 1 of Genesis, in the beginning, God created, and then actually verse 2, and the Spirit hovered over. Ruach is feminine. And then the term mercy, which is so linked to suffering, is it comes from the same root as the word womb. You know, and the picture in the Hebrew was gated waters, but it's womb love. Whenever you deal with mercy, you're dealing with womb love. And then the oldest translation we have of John 14, 15, 16 pieces, we only have fragments, it's called the Syriac, when Jesus says, when the Comforter comes, she, and uses the feminine pronoun. Mm. And it's not trying to make a case that, you know, there's one part of God that's female, but it's saying that our experience, I think, largely has been that comfort and that kind of wrapping around our losses has oftentimes come in feminine form in our own lives. It has for me.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times women showed up when men didn't have a clue how to. Yeah. And it's not been totally the case, but largely the case. Mm-hmm. So I like that language is wrapped inside of feminine qualities, and I think that the bonding and the connection too between a woman and a child is different than between the father and the child, just because they've carried this child, you know, for whatever period of time, and there's a visceral reality to that. So the work of the Holy Spirit is comfort. Holy Spirit is presence. The work of the Holy Spirit is exposure. When it says, I've come to convict the cosmos of brokenness, the unexposed is the unhealed.
Yeah.
And it's not done to humiliate us. It's done to move us in the direction of freedom and life and goodness.